Welcome back to our unit on equilibrium and our investigation of the equilibrium of smog. By now, I hope you've developed a detailed materials list and procedure for carrying out this investigation. So if you're ready, let's head back out to our classroom to join our students.
Let's start by reminding ourselves what our experimental question is. What is the goal when we're conducting this experiment?
We want to find out which gas is causing smog.
Good, Emma. That is what we're trying to do. So how about your team? What did you guys state as your goal?
We said our goal is to identify which gas is brown.
Okay, good. It sounds like our goals are consistent and clear. So let's review our procedures for the lab.
We plan to put a tube of gas mixture in a dry ice at minus 79 degrees Celsius, another in room temperature at 25 degrees Celsius, and a third one at hot water at 100 degrees Celsius. And we use a thermometer to test each one.
Then we'll compare the color of the gases in each tube at the different temperatures.
Okay, good. So what data do you guys plan to collect?
We're gonna describe the color of the gases at each temperature.
All right, that's a good start. Now remember, you'll need data to back up any conclusions that you make. And so you wanna think carefully about recording your data, so that'll help you support those conclusions at the end. What about your team? What did you guys say?
We'll set up three containers measuring three different temperatures with thermometers, like they said. I think we have a way to measure color. We want to use a color chart and match the shade of brown in each tube to one of the shades on the chart.
That sounds like a great idea to me. You'll need that reference so that later on others can understand what you're talking about when you're describing the colors. So have you thought about where you can get a color chart like that?
Well, we were thinking of getting one of those paint strips that shows all the different shades of brown.
Okay, great. Well, this sounds like both of you are off to a great start. So let's get our materials together and get started with the investigations. The gas tubes, the thermometers, the hot plates, and the ice are all available for you in the lab. You'll need to let me know if there are any other materials or supplies that you need. Now record careful observations, and you want to organize your data into a data table. And make sure that you always follow the safety procedures during the investigation. Anytime you're working with hot glassware or chemicals, you always have to have your safety glasses on. And please be careful handling the dry ice. You should always use crucible tongs when handling it, never your bare hands. And if glass gets broken at any point during the lab, you should step away from your lab station and call me over for help.
Look, the dry ice is already making the gas turn lighter.
Cool. I'll start recording some of our data.
Why don't we leave the tube in the hot water for a while?
I'll bet the hot water is making it darker if the ice is making it lighter.
We'll take a break here. If you have the materials available in your classroom, you should conduct this experiment now. If not, visit the Chemistry Matters Toolkit, where you'll find other suggestions for labs involving Le Chatelier's principle. Whatever lab you perform, take your time and write down all of the data you collect. Our students will do the same with this lab. When you're ready, we'll meet you at the top of the next video.